Welcome back to Portrait of Virtue. We're going to begin our study with a woman whose name is Tamar, and I've entitled this A Portrait of Righteousness. Tamar's story begins in Genesis chapter 38. Now, before we go into her story, I want to give you a little bit about her background. Tamar, scholars believe, was a Canaanite. Now, the Canaanites came from Ham, who was a descendant of Noah. Now, what happened was Noah, we all know, he built an ark that the Lord flooded the earth. And when the waters ceased and the earth dried up, Noah and his family and all the animals left. And Noah then built, the Bible says, a vineyard. Now, he built a vineyard and he actually got drunk off that vineyard. The Bible says that he was in an area naked, and his son, Ham, walked into him and saw his nakedness, went to go get his other brothers. Well, his two other brothers came in, but they walked backwards, and they carried a cloak to cover their father, Noah, so they wouldn't see his nakedness. Now, when Noah woke up, he knew exactly what happened, and he pronounced a curse upon the Canaanites. And if you read in Deuteronomy 7, God says how he wants his children to deal with the Canaanites. This is what he says: smite them, utterly destroy them, make no covenant with them, show no mercy unto them. You shall destroy their altars, break down their images, cut down their groves. In Zechariah chapter 14, we see that a Canaanite wasn't even allowed to enter into the tabernacle or even into the temple. So we see this, and yet we see a woman who is a Canaanite who is listed in the genealogy of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And what I love about that is, once again, we see that as we move in faith, God responds. And even though Tamar didn't do everything right, even though she, we'll read about her story. She dressed up as a prostitute. She had sexual relations with her father-in-law. And yet her father-in-law turned to her and said, "What you've done has been more righteous than I." We're going to study that later. And we see that God is a forgiving God, that he is a God, like we said in Bathsheba, of another chance. Thank God that he is a God of another chance. So we see, ladies, that Tamar didn't do everything right. We see that she didn't come from the best background. She didn't have the best lineage, but yet God used her. Now, ladies, I want to ask you this as we close this video. I want to ask you this question. What's holding you back? You know, I understand that we live in hard times. I understand, ladies, I talked to some of you, and I realize that there are moms out there that are working, that are full-time moms, full-time workers, and there's single moms that I also send this video out to. There's people with marriages that are hurting. There are people with finances that aren't in order. There are people that their children are rebelling. There are people out there that have lost their job. I understand, ladies, that we are living in hard times. But my question to you today, ladies, is this: what's holding you back? What's holding you back of being all that God has called you to be, from stepping out and living the God kind of life? I'm reading a book about, it's by John Maxwell, and it's a really good book about dreams and living your dream and not settling and not pushing back. And you know, you pursue your dream, and let's say it doesn't happen, but guess what? God will give you another dream. And he's talking about this, you know, just living the life that God has called you to live. And there's a quote that I want to give you, ladies, that it says this: never measure the height of a mountain until you have reached the top. Then you will see how low it was. I'm going to say it one more time. Never measure the height of a mountain until you reach the top. And then you will see how low it really was. You know, ladies, to be honest with you, it's a battle to get these Bible studies out, and not just time, not just, you know, you're working and you have kids and you have to study. I mean, a battle that the devil doesn't want us to study his word. He doesn't want the word going out. He doesn't want people's lives to be changed. And that's exactly what I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you, ladies, that are dedicated to this Bible study, that God will use these things, these tools, to encourage you, to strengthen you, to take you to the next level, you and your family to the next level. And you know, ladies, it's not easy. And there was a time when I was looking at all the obstacles that were before me and my family and all the things that were against me and all the things that I needed to overcome. And I started to look at the mountain and it just got bigger and bigger and bigger to one point in my life. It was so big that it actually shadowed the faithfulness of God. I didn't look at the faithfulness of God anymore. I was just looking at the mountain thinking, man, I can never do this. There's too much against me. There's too much that needs to get right. There's too much that needs to get in order. There's too much. And I looked at that mountain and one day I just started praying. I said, God, you are able to deliver by many or by few. I choose to be one to be delivered. I choose, God, to trust in your word. I choose that no matter what weapon forms against me, it's not going to prosper. I choose to trust you. And I'm going to do what you've called me to do. And I'm going to leave the rest to you, Father. And I was going to bed one day. And the Lord put this scripture in my heart. I look into the hills. From whence comest my help? My help comes from the Lord. And the Lord told me this. He said, Maria, your mountain is only a hill to me. That's why I love this scripture, or that scripture, and I love this quote. Never measure the height of the mountain that is before you, ladies, until you reach the top. Because I'm going to tell you, ladies, you're going to get to the top, and then you're going to see how low it really was. And what the Lord spoke to me, he wants to speak to you. The mountains that are holding you back are just hills to me. He could have put in the book of Psalms, in that particular psalm, I looked into the mountains, from when comes my help? My help comes from the Lord. No, he said, I look into the hill. Because I had a mountain before me of obstacle. And God said, Maria, those mountains are mountains in your eyes, but in my eyes they're only hills. And I choose to have the mind of Christ. I choose to see things as God sees them. And so I say with God, I look into the hills. From where comes my help? My help is coming from the Lord. He's the maker of heaven and earth. Nothing, ladies, is too difficult for him. And that's all I want to talk about. You can read Genesis chapter 38. We're going to get into more of Tamar's story, but I just wanted to do an introduction this week. And I want to tell you, ladies, that I'm praying for you. As you do the Bible study, as you listen, I'm praying that God will use it to touch you, to speak to you, to help you. I'm praying for your situation. I don't know everyone's situation, but God does. And I lift those up. I lift you up. And I ask you, ladies, to pray for me as well. Like I said, it's not easy to put these Bible studies together, but I choose to honor God. I'm going to choose to continue to go forward no matter what may happen. I'm going to honor God. And I ask you for your prayers. As I pray for you, I ask you to pray for me. Okay, ladies? Well, God bless you. We're going to talk more about Tamar next week.